today's session we will discuss about magnetic dipole moment and torque. Okay, next, how the current carrying loop behaves as a magnetic dipole moment. Okay, magnetic dipole moment is a torque experienced by a material placed in a uniform magnetic field. Okay, as in case of electric dipole moment, it is a pair of equal and opposite charges separated by distance r. So, and it electric dipole moment gives the strength of the electric dipole. So that we have studied that in electric means we are initial chapters only we have studied that. In case of magnetic dipole moment, I think expression wise you can write it as m is equal to I into h. So this is the expression for magnetic dipole moment, right? Magnetic dipole movement. And I want to know how this current carrying loop behaves as a magnetic dipole. Okay, current carrying any loop or any material behaves as a magnetic dipole. How it is behaving like that? Okay, look here. This is the lines of magnetic field. This is my S pole. This is my north pole. Okay, next, this is the direction of magnetic field. Okay, next, if the current is flowing in an anti-clockwise direction, right, it is coming like this, anti-clockwise, answer, yeah, it is anti-clockwise, then phase of the current carrying loop is N-fold. It acts as N-fold. So, phase of the current carrying loop is N-fold. Abhaag yeh nagatthi adhu, yaw tarayak nagatthi N-fold agatthi agatthi. Direction of current is clockwise direction. Current is flowing in a clockwise direction. Clockwise direction of the current is under. Phase of the current carrying loop gives as S4. If the direction of current is anti-clockwise like this, then phase of the carrying loop gives as north pole. Okay, so we cannot get only S pole and only N pole. Okay, these two poles are exist together. Okay, okay. So this is the, how you can get a magnetic dipole moment in a current carrying loop. Okay, the current is flowing in a clockwise direction. Thus, phase of the current carrying loop behaves as S pole. If it is anti-clockwise, then it behaves as north pole. So then you can observe a magnetic dipole moment there. Okay, it is clear. And one more thing, we can calculate the magnetic dipole moment. Okay, that we have studied in electrostatics, right? What is the expression for electric field due to electric dipole at a point on the axis of line? So this is the electric field. Okay, next, in case of magnetic field we know that we derive like what? So what is that? Magnetic field due to a point on the current carrying loop or the on the axis of current carrying loop. Okay, so like this, it is a point, and what is the magnetic field at this point due to this axis, like that. Okay, so derive that. What is that? Mu naught 4 pi 2 pi r square 2 pi I r square divided by r square plus x square raised to 3 by 2. Okay, so this is the expression we got by solving this. What is the magnetic field due to our magnetic field at a point due to a point on the axis of circular loop. Okay, next is, if r square or x is greater than, very much greater than r square, then we got mu naught divided by 4.25 r square into I divided by x square into, sorry, x square bracket, it is 3 by 2, right? X square 3 by 2. Then what happens? It becomes B is equal to mu naught by 4 pi 2 pi I r square divided by x cube, right? So then what is pi r square? Pi r square is the area of loop. If it is area of loop, then I can write B mu naught by 4 pi 2 pi r square is our A, then it is A divided by x cube. Mu naught divided by 4 pi. What is I into A? I into A is our magnetic dipole moment, right? So this is the expression. It is similar to this expression where you get A square like that. Okay. So here R is the radius of the circular loop and X is the point. X is the point of the axis like that. Okay. So this gives us the actual expression for how current carrying loop behaves as a magnetic expression. Or again, you can talk about it like this. Okay, M bandana, this magnetic dipole moment is there, so that this current carrying loop behaves as magnetic dipole. Atta, hey, atta. So this is all about today's session. I hope this is clear to you all. Thank you.